Happy New Year to you all, family. We thank you for being with us since last year to this particular year. God richly bless you. As you know, Kakus TV, we keep bringing you exciting and more enjoyable videos. Keep enjoying us. We'll be bringing you more exciting videos. As you know, I'm still your host, Senior Captain Sonny. In fact, the world is talking about addiction. Africans are talking about addiction. Chinese are talking about addiction. Everybody's talking about addiction. So tonight, I want us to dig into addiction. I want us to learn something about addiction and how we can solve the addiction. I'm still your host, as I said, Senior Captain Sonny. Let's begin. Addiction is a biopsychosocial disorder characterized by a repeated use of drug or repetitive engagement in a behavior such as gambling, desperate harm to self and others. Or addiction is an urge to do something that is hard to control or stop. You see, we have types of addiction or examples of addiction or types of addictive behavior. We have gambling addiction, we have sex addiction, we have food addiction, we have internet addiction, shopping addiction, love addiction, video game addiction, we have exercise addiction, we have work addiction, which I call workaholism or workaholic, we have pornographic addiction, and we have drug addiction. Talking of gambling addiction, that is what we call the betting addiction. You see, nowadays our generation, we have come to meet the betting and the lottery. So when we say gambling addiction, we mean that playing games of chance for money, the betting or staking of something of value with consciousness of restlessness and hope of gain on the outcome of a game. Betting, that is also an addiction. We have food addiction. Some people use food addiction to talk about a compulsive or uncontrollable urge to eat food that does not relate to feeling or hunger. They are not angry, but they feel like eating. It leads to obesity. Food addiction, we have to deal with that too. And then we have internet addiction. There is technically no such thing as internet or phone addiction. Some in the psychiatric community has proposed or programmed a new disorder called internet gaming disorder. It is also characterized by excessive or poorly controlled preoccupation. You understand? So the excessive use of internet is called it's an addiction. And then we have porn addiction. It refers to a person becoming emotionally dependent on pornography to the point that it interferes with their ability or it interferes with their daily life, relation, and ability to function. It affects their ability to function. It interrupts their ability to function. It interferes with their daily life, with their relationship. You see them encountering a lot of problems in their relationship because of pornographic addiction. And every now and then they want to watch a pornographic material, it being a movie, being it a picture or whatever, sound, they feel like enjoying all these things. It is an addiction that we have to deal with. I'm just throwing light on them so that when we start deep into them, you get to know where you fall into so you heal yourself. We have drug addiction. It also called substance use disorder. It's a disease that affects a person's brain and behavior and leads to an inability to control the use of a legal or illegal drug or medication. Substances such as marijuana, narcotic, we have tramadol, and etc. We have a lot of them. Now, let's look at some of the factors of addiction. Factors such as peer pressure, curiosity, physical and sexual abuse, early exposure to drugs, stress, and parental guidance can greatly affect a person's likelihood of drug use and addiction. What are the Bible says about addiction? Let's look at the book of Proverbs, chapter 25, verse number 28. A man without self-control, it's like a city broken into and left without a wall. It means that Bible compares a city broken into a life or broken into and left behind or without a wall. In fact, in other words, you are exposed to your enemies. It also means that you are there without protection and security. I hope you get me clear. Now, self-control is a major antidote God put in us to fight fleshly desires like addiction. Now, let me say it again. Self-control is a major antidote God put in us, man or woman, to fight addiction or fleshly desires. Self-control is a spirit and also a major weapon in the kingdom. Addiction is a brain disorder. I personally see it as a spirit that fights Christian and even godly people. Addiction can make you very vagabond whilst you are not. It can make you school drop out whilst you have not intended to. It can make you very stubborn. It can make you become a vagabond. It can make you live in the street whilst nobody has called you on the street. You get it? So that is called addiction. Addiction can make you choose certain friends in life that you are not supposed to. Addiction. So addiction can make you vagabond whilst you are not. Addiction can make your life very miserable and hopeless. Addiction can make you become hopeless. It can make your life very miserable. Addiction can make your life very miserable that people wouldn't have respect for you. People would dishonor you. You understand? Addiction can make you regret massively in life because it wouldn't make you successful. It would rather make you a failure and also make you useless on earth. Children, you call children and send them and they won't go because you have become useless because of an addiction. You have to deal with your addiction, being it drug, being it pornographic materials, being it food, being it whatever. You have to deal with it. You get it? Uh-huh. And then addiction is a destructive weapon which everybody must flee from it. In fact, it is one of the major trusted weapon of the devil, addiction. You see, we have to flee. We have to flee. You understand? The Bible says that we should flee from the enemy. So when we see the enemy, we must not walk. We should flee. Past tense of life. We should flee from addiction, because when addiction gets hold of us, it becomes very difficult. It becomes very cumbersome for us to refrain, for us to restrain from addiction. Therefore, we must not even go nearer to anything that we think can get effect, that anything that we think our soul or our spirit cannot get hold of. We have to get rid of it. Now, addiction, as I said, is a destructive weapon which everybody must flee from. In fact, it is one of the major weapons of the devil. Addiction is a devouring spirit. It kills both the spirit and the soul. You understand? Addiction is a devouring spirit. Addiction is roaming and is searching for the one who is available to devour. When you allow yourself, it will destroy you. Addiction. So addiction, you see, it's about pregnancies. I mean, a man carries a heavy destiny. When somebody carries destiny, addiction destroys and then aborts that pregnancy that the person carries. So when addiction gets hold of you, it destroys, it aborts pregnancies. I mean, it destroys destinies. It makes your life very miserable, as I said. It destroys your life. It makes you very hard to become successful. Now, it is addiction that makes you think you are always right, even if you are wrong, or even if you are at fault. It is addiction. Addiction can make you think whatever you are doing is right. Addiction can make you think whatever you are doing, whether it is evil or not, you think is good for you. It doesn't easily make you accept fault. It makes you shift blames. And remember, shifting of blames is an attribute for the devil. It's an accuser of the blessing, accuser of the brethren. So when you keep accusing people for your fault, you keep accusing people for your trouble, you keep accusing people for what you are going through, it means that you are under influence, addiction. Please, let's learn to deal with addiction. As you know, today I won't keep longer with you. As time goes on, tomorrow same time, we will meet. And I'll be giving you how to deal with addiction, how to break long addiction, and how when you are being catapulted or when you are getting gripped by addiction, how you can deal with it within a month or within weeks, how to deal with that addiction. In fact, God bless my CEO, Nana Kwao, and my cameraman, Joseph Kaku. I'm still your host, Senior Captain Sonny.
Please subscribe, like, and share.